partial prohibition in liquor in Kerala. You see, we can't, the only the high star or like 5-star hotels can serve hard liquor in Kerala. And I totally do support this, you know, because I had an uncle who was so drunk that he used to make cows at home every day with my auntie. And she had so much trouble with this. But after the government had made this law and the court has supported this, we have such a peaceful atmosphere at our house, because he was a kind of person who could have controlled it, and the government, with the government support, he had made it possible.
You're saying that now it is peaceful, right?
Yes.
But I don't okay, if he can't go drink at bar, he can buy from the beverage, he can bring it home and drink there. Nothing is changed. Okay? Doesn't matter. Or if you're talking about the people that only high class people are allowed to drink. Is there any rule that only high class people are allowed to drink? No, na? Everyone can drink?
Yes.
Then why the normal bars and we are being closed? Doesn't make any sense. Second point. What's the main income of the Kerala? Liquor. Isn't it?
Is it?
It is.
And it's not about only high class people can drink. It's about controlling. Controlling, it's in a certain extent. When the poor people, more, according to the consumption statistics, more than 70% consumers are from poor class. They're doing their works and they're, consuming these drinks by their daily wages. So it indirectly affect poverty and so many families and making so many clashes and all. So it is not about only high class people can drink. It's about maintaining or making a social control to a certain extent.
Actually, this partial ban does not reduce any liquor consumption in Kerala, because the high class people, as he said, can drink from the 5-star hotels, yeah. And ordinary people buy from beverages, yeah. And so there is nothing like that. There is a rejection to liquor is not possible by this partial ban, and also rejection to liquor is something which should come from our minds, which should be voluntarily we should decide. So ban is not a easy thing.
Siddharth, it's not only mind, we need certain actions. If you want to attain a big target, first you have to start small. Okay, we know that tiny drops makes an entire ocean, isn't it? So this particular prohibition of liquor, especially prohibiting 730 bars to be specific in Kerala, will empower all actions against liquor, not only in the state, but also in the various nook and corner of the country. So it's an initiative. Let's welcome it.
Kerala government get more resources from the tourism and extra things. So even the liquor plays an important thing. According to Article 47, let me complete. According to Article 47 of Indian Constitution, it is clearly stated that it is the responsibility of the government to ensure the public health and prohibit the intoxicating drinks except drugs. Except medicine. So that is what the government did. So we are supposed to support it.
No, in a civilized country, you need bans. You can't go against ban. Okay, coming to alcohol also, in India, alcohol is always, or liquor is always against women, only in India. Because majority of the men is having a traditional, conventional way of living in our country. So if you take a stand against liquor, then you are supporting women empowerment. See, go through the atrocities of women, how they face violence in home, domestic violence, mainly because of the consumption of alcohol. In Kerala, in Tamil Nadu, in other parts of our country, women are suffering, struggling. So if you want to help them, we have to start an initiative. I am not saying that alcohol or liquor is the only thing, but it is also there.
I totally agree with what you're saying. There are problems of drinking, but the banning is not a proper solution for that. As he said, you know, alternative. There are certain, CCC, there are certain, I can tell you. One thing is, like, you can reduce the quantity that is given to a particular person, provide them, the state should provide them good quality liquor with less intoxicants. So that, you know, you can reduce the intoxicants, okay? And, you know, violence against women, marital rape, CCC, marital rape.
Then spiritual thing will change, huh?
Excuse me, marital rape is very common. It's not by drunkard husbands, you know, usual men do that, you know. It's the attitude of people that needs to be changed towards things. It's
but
not about liquor or something.
Don't you think that this was only a political gimmick aiming at a vote bank? This partial ban was a political gimmick aiming at vote bank and complete corruption.
So what could they earn from a ban?
Yes, what happened, the after effects and reports, the newspaper reports suggest that there is a high amount of corruption which values about crores was happened after this bar, the banning of bars.
When you're economically speaking a thing, you know, there are exceptions. You know, when you talked about when the price is increasing, the demand reduces. There are exceptions to the law of demand. No. You know, for certain goods are there which give you addiction or luxury. Okay, such goods, even if the price increases, the consumption equally increases. So this is the case with banning. If you ban something, the consumption is going to double itself.
There's a political reason also in this particular topic. The Congress party is put forwarding this initiative, but I don't think LDF supports or backs this particular decision. They have certain political interest also. So a political concept is also there in this particular topic. We must accept it.
This is something which is very economical issue and very political also. When you talk about politics, it's just that, you know, if the when the bars are getting banned, you told, right, the black market stuff, yes, they'll pay the ministers extra. Yes. So you can get a lot of profit from that.
Actually, let's stop the politics here and get into the real facts, actually. Yes, we can't skip politics. Yes, we can't skip politics.
No,
but there are...
economical.
We can't just put something away saying that it's just a political agenda. It has some social cause, it has some social values. It is affecting the lives of so many people.
Like a layman, he earns 100 rupees a day. In olden times, he used to spend 50 rupees for drinking and 50 he used to give his wife. Now, he's not able to afford it. So he'll go to five-star hotel. He'll spend 100 on drinking. That's the psychology of people. There is zero savings and non-profitable business. It's not socially helping us. He will not sit at home and say, oh my God, my hands are shivering. I need a drink. He's not going to ding that, you know. He's going to do all the psychopath things, you know, because the withdrawal symptoms are too high, he can even die. A human life is much important than any other thing.
Yes. As you said, this also have exceptions. And in a state like Kerala, where women are also having some power with them, I don't think this layman concept is... It's actually impossible.
The point for consideration is, we can say that the liquor gives revenue to the state or not. But the thing is, the implications created by the liquor, the government has to pay more on that, especially the medicine, especially the hospital expenses. So it is more about the revenue aspect. So this has to be considered.
Yes, we should give more importance to the de-addiction. We should have to formulate a good action plan, and we want to do it step by step. We want to free our state from all these problems.